Hello everybody, welcome to my channel RR Simple Recipes. Now I am going to make a dish called potato kurma. White potato kurma. So let us see what are the things required for grinding. I have taken 4 tablespoons of grated coconut, freshly grated coconut. 1 teaspoonful of lemon juice. 1 small ginger and 2 green chilies, 1 and half teaspoon of roasted Bengal gram or pottukadalai, then 1 tablespoonful of cashew nut, some coriander leaves, then fennel seeds and 3 cloves. Then finally the important thing is kasakasa or poppy seeds. 1 teaspoonful of poppy seeds. So all these things we have to grind it into a paste. So let us put one by one in the small mixie jar. Coconut, lemon juice, poppy seeds, ginger and green chilies, fennel seeds and cloves, roasted Bengal gram, coriander leaves and cashew nuts. We have to grind all these things into a paste. Now everything grinded into a fine paste. The other things required are, I have taken 4 boiled potatoes cut into pieces, square pieces. 1 big onion, cut it into lengthwise. And 2 medium sized tomatoes cut into pieces, medium sized pieces. Salt, and for seasoning we need 1 bay leaf, some fennel seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 1 piece of cinnamon and 2 cloves. And curry leaves, mustard and cumin seeds and 1 red chilli. This is for seasoning. Now boil 1 1/2 teaspoon of oil in the pan and add mustard, cumin seeds, red chillies, curry leaves, bay leaves, fennel seeds, cinnamon and cloves and fry it. Fry well. When the mustard starts crackling, add onion and fry well. When the onion turns light brown, now add tomato and stir well. Now itself the aroma is awesome. When the tomato turns soft, little soft, then add the potatoes. Along with that, add the salt also and mix it well. Mix it thoroughly and it won't take much time because the potatoes are already boiled. Now add the ground paste. And mix it well. Now add little water too. Now the kurma started boiling. Let us cover it with the lid and cook it for some 3 minutes. Let the raw smell of the coconut go. After 3 minutes, let us open the lid and see. The aroma is awesome. This is very nice and the kurma is well cooked. I am going to switch off the stove and I am going to transfer the kurma into another vessel. Now the kurma is ready to serve. This is very tasty and it goes very well with rice, chapati, puri, parotta, etc. etc. Everybody should try this and taste this and find it yourself. Thanks for watching my video. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my video. Thanks very much.